They're Danes.
I don't know what they're doing, to be fair. I think we'll need to maybe just keep a camera on them rather than any of us right now, because they're in a pretty damn good mood, and I can imagine as to why after that first map. However, map two, as everyone noting, different beast here. Inferno coming up. Something a little different now is as well the attitude Na'Vi are going to be bringing into this. You know, Sam was saying they're going to be fired up. You know, they're going to want to take this one now. They wanted to fight back after getting so close in that previous map. Are you of the same sort of thought train there?
Yeah, I mean, they had a nice discussion outside in between these maps, talking things over, very calm, very collected. Yeah. And yeah, that's the thing. Yeah, they started out really, really slow. Actually, I mean, to bring the TQM, when we were over grabbing lunch, and they were already at their computer setup, warming up and everything like that, so they made sure they came into this one hot. And you could see Na'Vi, they started out 0-8, didn't really get anything going for quite some time in that first half, but when it eventually did pick up, you know, even with the benefit of that CT side, you could see how much of a struggle they caused in TQM. So hopefully coming out into this map, ready to go as the analyst seems to think, it's going to be tough. It's going to be very, very tough. Guardian's got to come alive, and you know, I've talked about it a lot. This is a difficult map for Oppers on the T side. So, you know, it's going to have to fall on Flame. It's going to have to fall on this guy, Edward, to show up and make some space for the rest of his team.
Lots of ifs and buts here, really, for Na'Vi, and it's hard to put, not necessarily faith into them after the first map, but, you know, that start was blisteringly good for TQM. But then again, you know, the end, the closer was too bad for Na'Vi either, but I want to see what happens when you get someone like Guardian mad. That's what I want to see is, you know, because he started to make these really aggressive plays. He started to really go for those plays on train as well. So he's one of the players as well who can play that T side with the AWP. So even if they start out on T, I'm wondering what he can really do here. But then again, it's not like this is a bad map for TQM.
No, not whatsoever. Yeah, and this is why everyone's kind of like, yeah, there's definitely, you know, a chance that this goes to the third map, is because both these teams, I mean, you could see the map vetoes, they got maps that both teams like. So it is just going to be a little bit of a brawl. The scary thing is TQM still, you know, laughing, smiling, having a good time. And that kind of attitude, we saw what it did on train. They just kind of beasted in that first half and sent Na'Vi packing.
It is almost polar opposites, isn't it? You look at these guys, you could like split it right down the middle, and it's north and south at the moment. Just completely stoic by nature, Na'Vi. And on the other side, like the happy Danes, just cheerfully, you know, running around the place. And even in warm-up, I've never seen Edward look so intense. This is kind of terrifying. We'll have to see what they can bring now once we get into this, of course. It's yet to be seen. It's all good being mad. It's all good playing to that. But you can make mistakes. You can get annoyed at yourself, take needless battles, take needless peaks. It can be the downfall as well. But a veteran side from start to end, really, you know, excluding maybe Flamey, but certainly no one's going to question his performances of late. He's been becoming more and more of a powerhouse as we see this going along, but still. TQM against these guys. I don't know. Where's your prediction here? Do you think we're going to a third map?
No.
You think this is done and dusted, game over?
Well, no, but I mean, let's not go that far. But
oh, I can't
TQM,
make
this
statement.
Is the first time it's so long that we've seen TQM play, you know, they seem like stress-free. They seem like they have no pressure on them, and you know, when we saw them at like IAM, when we've seen them in the past at tournaments, they seem like just to be doubting themselves. And like coming in now, especially after that first map, they just, you know, seem calm, collected. They seem, you know, back at it.
Well, I think it was Carrigan as well who tweeted out relatively recently, like, you know, after these results, you know, hope everything's going to be okay in the near coming future. You know, it sounded very, you know, pessimistic, very down on it, but maybe just some reassuring words, let's say, from either, you know, whatever team or organization they're joining or whatever it was, or just keeping this roster as present, has kind of settled them back down, because it can be stressful times. I think that was discussed earlier on the desk as well. When you're in between homes and you're still having to, you know, keep that in mind, your TSM weren't exactly the most forthcoming with support for these boys. It can end you. It can just, you know, annoy your kind of overall team composition. So hopefully that's now at the back of their minds and they can kind of just continue forward. But I'm still wondering, what's going to define these two teams here? Like, who else can step up for Na'Vi? Because we had Zipnix being, you know, the headline, right, for TQM, which is, when you've got people like Carrigan, you've got, you know, Device, arguably one of the most consistently good players in the world. You know, Olaf always goes off on these tears, right? But Device is always there. He's always played these very good games, apart from the occasional mess-ups. But I really hope you can hear that. Like, I really...
Brilliant. Why not?
These guys, I swear to God. It's like, let's try and hype this up, and they're just making like these noises in the corner.
It's a war cry.
It is. It's incredible. And I hope they keep that coming in the next couple... All right, I'm just going to put my headset on their desk. but the war cry doesn't work.
It's unreal.
All right, so there we go. That's how it breaks down. I need to take a second. I'm done here. I'm done, guys. It's as bad as casting Sean Garris at this, right? Jesus.
You know, it's all well and good until you lose that knife route, and now you're looking at a T-side Inferno, and it's, you know.
It's like just that smile with a little tear just rolling down your cheek, like it could have been our moment. It
turns into like nervous laughter. Like, oh God, what have we done?
We can't show the fear now. We've made weird noises. They expect things from us. But still, let's break this down now, because we can imagine that's going to be a CT side start for NaVi. Would you?
That's huge. That's massive. I mean, we saw what they did. You know, even Train massively CG side of map, much like Inferno. And there's a lot of parallels here where, you know, the first five rounds for the Terrace team on Inferno are so crucial. And if you can, you know, keep battering the economy of the defense, if you can keep them low on what they can buy in terms of nades, in terms of kits, like retakes are so important, smokes are so important. If you can keep those, like, you can keep them out of their hands as much as possible in the first five rounds, that's really where Terrace teams can grind out all the rounds they'll need for the half. You know, how many times do we see a Terrace side team go up 5-0 on this map, and then the losing bonus builds up for the defense, and all of a sudden they get right back into it because they finally have all the money? But that's the thing. You know, if you get to five rounds so quickly, all of a sudden you're looking at a really, really strong half. You only have to win one or two more, and then it's like firmly in your favor.
Many of factors could be playing into this one then. We'll keep the eyes on the economy because let's remember last time they were able to keep that AWP away from Guardian for so long. Will TQM be able to achieve that now, so on the T side here on Inferno? It may be a very different matter altogether, but we are about to get this one started. So ladies and gents, it's currently sat at 1-0 in favor of TQM, turning up like no other on Train right off the start. But now we're on Inferno, and NaVi have arguably the upper hand here.
Yeah, and there, I mean, that helps too. Guardian just swinging across middle, confidently taking that shot. Flamey's brought down very low in return, so not able to quite equalize the player count, but Flamey, he's got to be very careful in the battles that he picks.
He certainly does, and a bit of a flash going to come through. C's just backs away, not too fast here, but device going to be smoked out. But while that happens, you can see that Edward's got two players pushing in towards him. Zipnix to the right, Dupree to the left. They've actually not fully cleared either. Right now they're going to, at least they go back, double check. Dupree removes him. And I'm back down to a 4v4.
Yeah, and Guardian wasn't there to support. Normally there's a player at the end of halls to really help out, you know, the player in bedroom, but Guardian doesn't get there quick enough, so his teammate Edward just dies basically for free almost. And now it's down to a 4v4. Now the defense has got to really pick things. You can see they're split in a 2v2 at each bomb site. But question mark in this situation has the big advantage. It's gonna be in 4v2 no matter where they go.
Device. Here from the start, to be fair, it's going to be seized to try and stop them, joined by Flamey, and already this has gone pretty southern until right then. Dupree and Zipnix going to come back in.
What?
Dupree just finds Zeus. Was that through the smoke, or was there a gap? I actually don't know.
That was just a drive-by. I didn't even stop. Just started
just
shooting into the smoke.
Down.
Very, very lucky.
Guardian, let's see what you can achieve. Already getting the great little shot at the start. Little sweep pass on mid. He's looking in the right place, but there's not going to be the time for this one. Zipnix is there with a nice little crossfire. That pistol round will go to TQM.
Very good defense for NaVi initially at that B site. Flamey does the smart thing. He only has 4 HP, so he goes and plays with the spindles where it's just a headshot angle. This is, you can see Guardian there on the X-ray trying to jump up on the truck to get there. And yeah, just couldn't make it in time. And this shot from Dupree is just, we don't get to see it. But we heard the ending
of
it.
We just got teased by it, but still. Four SMGs, I guess, and one rifle. I find it hard to kind of put the UMP in that bracket as well, but it is by default, but can work so well. Got a four-play stack as well from NaVi towards B.
Yeah, this is a little scary now for TQM if they commit to this, but you can see Device of the P90, he spots two. Spotted one close up on the left, and he's gonna get that kill. Pop flash coming out a little bit late, but it's traded off by Guardian. And now both teams just kind of slow things down, not willing to take too many more fights at this region of the map. And you can see TQM quickly reconvening over towards the A bomb site.
Yeah, and you could see even instantly the device backed away from that. Edward had a little bit of a drop then for a second, but Zipnix is going to just remove him from the equation. And that's three players now remain. They're going to actually recover the SMG. I'm surprised that no one from TQM either wanted to pick that up or drop it off the side, really. You can easily put it up there. But still, it does mean that we're going to have Flamey with the Deagle, something that did a lot of damage. Guardian with the P250 and Seize with a little bit of something to work with, but they do have the armor and they don't really want to be losing out on that.
Oh, Zipnix doesn't care what they want. He just drops Flamey. Nice headshot, long range. I was about to say, this is smart from Na'Vi, not even getting anywhere near that A bomb site. Just try and keep those weapons alive, bring the armor, the upgraded pistols into the next round, see if you can do some damage then. Zipnix with different ideas, though.
Guardian's so tentative to try and pick this up as well.
Oh,
oh my word, hello. Did get one, but sacrificed his life for it in the end. And three stay alive for TQM. One with Steezed as well, and he does keep at least the SMG to hand, so maybe looking to put that into place. You know, into this round, hopefully do a little bit of damage here, because looking at TQM, they're building well. Not the cleanest of rounds, but they're doing just fine. You know, they've been killed five times overall, so it's not exactly the end of the world for them so far. They've been relatively well invested here, and Cajun just going to be opting just for the Tech-9, the MAC-10 with Kerrigan, P90 for device. Nothing too surprising, really. They've just upgraded one rifle, pretty much.
Yeah, once again a stack for Na'Vi, this time towards the A-bomb site. So they have that SMG, and a Molotov is going to force Seized away. He was in that corner, but they're going to force him out. That smoke prevents him from really appropriately clearing the corner, because you can see he's going to actually get aggressive here. It almost looks like he wants to scout things out. He has no backup, and he hears all these bullets from the P90, and he chooses his time wisely, gets that kill, and he's even able to fall away. He survives. Really well done from Seized, but Na'Vi still with a really tough time ahead of him.
Well, it was going so well until that moment. You know, device just takes the angle above the smoke, hits the shot, quick smoke towards the CT cross, and there you have that bomb could be on B, but it's not. It's still sitting on banana, which is possibly a problem, but Zipnix, oh my word, lurking from the depths, has just heard everything. He even takes his time on the fourth there to make sure he can come right round the back lines. Eventually lines him up, takes down Guardian, and is going to be pinched in from both sides here. They know exactly what's going on. Zipnix flashes out nicely, if intended as such, and Cajun B will find Zeus.
That first bullet accuracy. Zipnix was so confused. He was like, oh, all right, so that happened. But either way, nice round from TQM.
Oh, thank you for
hiring
that production again.
There it is, nicely. But once TQM gets that first kill, once they take out Seize, you have that SMG, they're like, all right, so they have the gun here. You know, let's press forward. More than likely, it's a stack over towards the ESEA with the strongest weapon solo, and they don't find anything. So, but they still sent device in all by himself, and this is the important round for Na'Vi now. If they lose this round, you know, they're light on utilities. They have no kits. They're already down to four smokes very, very early on. I mean, this is the round now where TQM very quickly get up to five rounds, and they can just grind things out. This could be a very dangerous half if Na'Vi can't close this.
Certainly could be. Kerrigan be opting to stick with that P90. Not too surprising at this point. We've been seeing Envy doing such for a long, long, long time running. And already Zipnix going to be flashing out. They're trying to get some presence. And actually, they work brilliantly up towards mid, but they're playing from these apps here, Na'Vi. Two players make it three, actually, all locking this one down. Kerrigan and Dupree both fall to that. Just going to put back to this 4v3. This is a very unique way of playing this one from Na'Vi. Going to adjust around towards quad there for Seized. Drop out the molly, buy some time, but suddenly device breaks open that B side. They know that's going to be clear. They've spotted out almost all of those players on towards A, and not even a smoke in place. Device wants to fight, and he might just land one shot and take it.
Yeah, Guardian's got to be very careful, and that's the thing. Really smart play from TQM when it's down to a 3-on-3. And they know they saw two players at A, so device knows that at the worst he's got a 1-on-1, but Seized is going to open things up with the first kill. So down to a 3-on-2.
Engagement B's pretty far away. Now, of course, they don't know that by now. Device is the only man really close to this. Engagement B's going to be watching that cross. No one's pushed for it yet. Guardian's the one holding the peak here. So depending on how this one goes, this could go very southern very, very quickly here. And Device just buying time, keeping this one ticking, allowing Cajun B to do the damage. And a great little back and forth between those two, pulling these Na'Vi players left, right, and center.
Yeah, so well done by TQM in that 2-on-3. Very, very nice setup to have. Hit some good shots, but either way, Na'Vi, they had to be a little bit more aggressive. They had to take a little bit more of initiative anyways, because they had no kits into that round. So they didn't really have time to play too much. But either way, TQM just kind of demolishes them. So really good decision in the mid-round to just go for that strong B hit in the 3-on-3. And it pans out for them. So now they've got that fourth round. Now, once again, Na'Vi's going to be on the pistols.
Yeah, this is not looking great. This is kind of flashbacks to how that last map started, almost like, okay, everything's starting to go in TQM's favor. They're building up the economy really nicely here. And maybe Na'Vi just decide they want to only win, you know, at the very end of the battle when they can do. But still, Kerrigan's gone for the MAC-10. Duly noting that Na'Vi are going to have minimal funds to work with. Zeus, they're going to have the CZ with a little dash of head armor there. But it's, once again, just two players on towards A. Kerrigan backs out, flashed up. But in the meantime, Zipnix over on towards the A side. It's going to be picking up a kill. But Zeus had the drop for a second, but no one close by that CZ. Not able to connect as perfectly as he would have wanted. Tries to work with that trigger discipline to try and just pick up something. But not going to come with it. And now Flamey just the last man standing. Gonna catch out one, gets a rifle. But Zimnix doesn't want to leave that with him.
Yeah, there's no way he gets out of this round with this weapon. He's pushing forward, and there it is. Aim punch, Flamey can't even respond. He even drops an AK-47 over towards Kerrigan, who had a MAC-10, so they bring all the rifles into the next round. Nicely done, just a small detail there. But now Guardian's got the AWP, now it begins.
Okay, so last time it took, I think, if I'm not mistaken, about two or three attempts for Guardian until he actually made a difference with the AWP in map in train in map one. He needs to kind of get going quickly on this. He doesn't want to let this one slip. So let's see if he can be the difference. Again, the pressure, the one man to do it all. But already the Molly's to deny the peek towards Banana, going to keep him humble at this point. Allow Cajun be a little bit more room to work up Banana here. Perfect flash, allow the swing up, but no shot's going to be connecting as well as they'd hoped here.
I don't know if that was just the power of Guardian scaring Cajun from peeking and committing to that fight, or if maybe Cajun got blind, but either way, Guardian was dead to rights.
Yep.
But he gets away from it, so nicely done either way by TQM. Now they have Banana control, and Sean talked a lot yesterday on Inferno. You have to be able to control Banana. You cannot allow the defense to cheat a fourth player over towards the A site. That just becomes too difficult. So they have Banana control. You can see Device there just looking into the wall in case there's a pop flash peek. But TQM has everything they want out of the first 30, 40 seconds of this round.
What can they make from this now? Two players on Banana, three toward A. The bomb nowhere near being committed anywhere at this point.
The bomb's actually almost right back in Terra spawn.
Yeah.
There's 35 seconds left. Someone's got to go pick that up. I don't know if that was a mistake.
Device heading through. It might have been a mistake by this point. Maybe just scared and they had a good spawn on Device. Who knows what they just did at that point. But now with 28 seconds, maybe taking a little bit of leaf out of Na'Vi's book by complete error more than anything. They've been making a play towards A here. Two players on this site, Edward and Zeus. Edward down in pit there, just going to be looking through. Zeus on the side, watching for that push out from Zipnix. But the wraparound comes in from Library. And look at these guys, just in towards the side we go. But Zeus is still alive. But no, he gets swept aside. And suddenly, full control on towards A, going to be given over. But a great little step out from Cease. Picks up three. Kerrigan, Zipnix, Dupree, fallen. But time is going to run out. And the CT side finally get into the game.
That's incredible. TQM played that round. I mean, even considering the bomb was left so far away, that execution was perfect. They got everything they wanted. They even froze Cease. He rotated over towards the B bomb site at the fake earlier in the round, and he stayed for so long. But what a performance coming back. That triple kill just saves the round for him, especially because of the bomb. And that's the thing. That's, once again, timer starts running very, very low on TQM, and just losing the bomb at one critical moment cost the round.
Guardian this time a little more hesitant to get up to that yellow car, just knowing these guys are willing to commit that utility towards it and deny that peek and go for the swing out. But this time, Na'Vi backing away accordingly. And at least for this round, TQM have remembered to bring the bomb with them.
Yeah, they're just going to body their way up towards bracket, so they have control. Cease just throws a molly on the choke point. He's going to peek with that flashbang. He gets one before being traded off, so no triple kill for him this time. But TQM look like they want to push forward. They throw some more flashbangs into the site. They've pulled one rotator over from B bomb site. It's just Device playing solo over here. Nading and flashing, putting some pressure, and now all TQM is here, and the rotation is just now on its way from Guardian, but he has an op. He's going to get smoked off and got to get very fortunate, but he's actually just rushing right up.
Has anyone got a smoke left for TQM?
No, they don't. They're out.
They're all out, and this is going to open up the window of opportunity for Guardian, something you definitely don't need to do for him. Kerrigan's going to find one, and here we go. Guardian on the go here. Two kills already into this round. So imperative. But Zipnix trying to get that bomb down. But Guardian knows better, and now it's a 1v1 basically on this side here. And Guardian goes wild. Outstanding play from him. And sure, you know what? People can say he's the one player to the four others, but he just shows you exactly what one man can do time and time again. Kerrigan goes down, and look at this. He backs away, he readjusts, takes that shot towards Cajun, but then he just hands it all by himself. Hell, by this point, Edward and Zeus were still alive.
Yeah,
this is like, does anyone else need to be there, or is it just him? He's good.
Incredible, and that's kind of the bummer, too, for TQM, is one smoke, and that doesn't happen. But either way, there's Guardian making the impact like you talked about. Have it again in this round, and he's got a very good spawn for a mid-peak, so he might choose to switch things up, get a little bit aggressive, maybe turn around for some kind of a pop flash early on, but no, he's just going to go for it. But there's the pop flash. Blinds him. He takes the shot anyways, just in case, but no one from TQM gets punished.
TQM. I'm wondering if maybe these are the small pieces of communication errors or just, committing too much utility too early on.
That was the thing. It almost looked like they wanted to continue with that A hit after they got that initial trade down into a 4-on-4, and they called it off at the last second. And maybe they didn't realize at the time they didn't have any smokes for that cross, or else I think they would have just kept pushing forward. And Guardian, as Zoe said, he's going to look for kills. He wants to go for it. Now he's got to run back through a Molotov, but he does get away and find a new angle.
Backs away. And now, if that wall wasn't there, just one wall between a hell of a lot of death, but Zeus in a really nice spot here, gonna flash out, gets the one-to-one. Up against Kerrigan, gonna take the fight again, actually loses out on the swing out there. And that means Guardian again has to wait on the edge of this smoke. Seas has put himself towards CT Arch this time, finally deals with two players, again, racking them up as they push through. And Edward being a linchpin as well, up towards that balcony. Seas goes for a little more, but by now, it looks like NaVi have the upper hand.
Yeah, 30 seconds left though, and Zipnik's just holding this angle, trying to see if he can find maybe a little bit of a fortunate kill. He's the one who's got to make a play. He's got 100 HP. He's got one in the pit to deal with underneath him. Guardian, though, out in the open. No cover for him. Almost gets taken out. But it's going to be Edward underneath who's going to start causing the real issue for Device, who's pushing up with only 13 HP in the bomb. But blind is Guardian, and he falls. And Zipnix, he's going to get a second one. He's opened everything up for TQM.
One man again stands tall, but it's Flamey to deny any hopes for a big performance and coming out from Zipnix. But you said he was the one who had to open it up. And he took down two. He did everything he could, but in the end, it was just pulled back in time. So let's kind of recap what's happened here, because it seems that, once again at the start, TQM, super powerful, very proficient, working really well with the early advantages off the back of that pistol. But suddenly, NaVi have started to wake up a bit here.
Yeah, but still, TQM doing a lot of damage. You look at this buy out of them. They know the economy for NaVi is very, very low, so they go for this 3-tech-9. Saw Envy work into much success earlier in the day. And now they're at a position where just winning one round, this can punish NaVi and force him to save immediately. And, you know, let's talk about, too, because Guardian, you had that flashy 4-kill round. He's been, you know, having some very, very nice shots we've seen, but it's been Seas. His work on the rap side, you know, rotating back from the B-bomb side has been stellar. Two kills in that last round. We saw that triple kill round that he had earlier. I mean, it's just been really, really good play from him.
Yeah, it has been. And it's such a hard place to be in as well. You're constantly playing retake. He's constantly in these kind of awkward predicament, so credit where it's due. He has been playing well, but those four players over by A may be punished now, as it looks like they're going to be heading back around, and actually Zeus has rejoined them now.
Look at this. This is a really good read from NaVi. They rotate Zeus over. Seas is already there as well. I mean, they saw something that just said that TQM is going to be going towards this B bomb site, so this is going to be a very, very difficult take.
Yeah, it's suddenly gone really, really hard mode here for TQM. It's Flamey just doing what he does best, just spraying him down here. Kerrigan, Cage, and all four. And it's a real shutdown there from NaVi. And I don't know what indicated that, but something did. And instantly, those two players just heading right over there.
Yeah, and that was just running the gauntlet if you're TQM. With that extra player, there's two Molotovs laid down that they had to run through. There's the smokes they have to go through. For their own flashbangs, they're just trying to desperately allow them to gain a foothold into that B-bomb site. Nothing works out. They just get slaughtered. So now it's going to be basically a full save. Well, they have the Deagles. They have the Tech-9s. But, you know, only Zipnix has Zipnix and Kerrigan both have armor. Not too much utility, though.
Already Guardian's going to start things off with a bang. Let's do Pre-Gon, but not going to get much luck in this map at the moment. NaVi actually playing relatively aggressive on Banana. That could be a problem. It's Cajun B to make the most of that. C's going to be picked up, but no rifles yet to be found. But the pressure towards that balcony is going to become rather apparent, as it is Zipnix who's made his way out. Zeus nicely turns that flash, but Zipnix, oh my word! He got, how the hell did he just get two? This means the Flamey's now in a really bad spot. They know exactly where he is. The bomb's off to A. And Zipnix has turned something that was impossible into a round that actually could go in their favor.
Yeah, this guy came to play today after that first map. Now he's at 13-5, but that was a beautiful play. And I mean, you're right. NaVi played that very aggressively. One gets picked off down a banana, and then Zipnix is able to just capitalize on things. A 3-kill in this round, and now Device knows exactly where Flamey is, and he's stuck. He's got nowhere to go. Although he does eventually win against Device, none of the other members from TQM have actually pushed on this. You're definitely not wanting to lose that AWP if they're going to bring that into the next round, but Flamey is going to be able to survive with this M4, it looks like.
And do you know what? The last round we said Zipnix has to be the one to make the kill through balcony and such and so on. Do you know what? It was quite impressive he did that with a rifle, but he was like, hey guys, let me show you what else I can do with just a Tech-9 against, you know, fully bought up NaVi and basically win the entire round. Like, look at this. Like, he's already taken down one. That was Edward gone by now. Zeus turns the flash well, but in the meantime, he picked up Guardian then and then followed back up.
Well, that's the thing, too, because that player in sight didn't know that he had gotten his way into pit until he saw the flash come out. So Guardian definitely had no idea. He was stuck in the open over towards small pit. So, I mean, Zipnix just surprised him and then wins the second battle. What a hero play out of him.
Again, this man, you know, train was something of a spectacle, but this is another big star for him. But Guardian going to begin a little toasty there on Banana. Going to have to back away from this, and it does give Cajun B a step towards it.
Yeah, but of course he just pushes forward. I mean, why not? He's going to lose that battle, but that's Guardian for you. He wants to go. He was hungry. He wanted those kills. Gets punished by Cajun. And that's the thing. It's also not, you know, that's a play that you don't often think is going to occur when, you know, you molly and nade him back. There's a second molly thrown out. You don't think there's any indication that the defense is going to push through that.
I guess you've got to test the water sometimes, right? But it's going to be Edward and Zeus to pull this one back towards Na'Vi's favor. And there's Seized again, making his appearance and making these spray downs that have been so perfect until now. Just really prevalent. I'm wondering if he can keep this sort of performance up, because that is a very dangerous Na'Vi. Suddenly Flamey shuts it down. Are you seeing Na'Vi coming back very close into this one? But still, as you said, it's not been the Guardian show, really. It's not been, you know, Flamey this time. It is Seized.
Yeah, Seized with some impact kills. And we see these matches out of him. Yeah, I know he had one over at Cluj. He had a couple where he was just beasting. So he's a very dangerous player if he gets started. And having a good match here, I mean, TQM at 6 rounds already, they're very, very happy with this.
Yes.
But, like, Seized is just holding Na'Vi in this as well as he possibly can.
Yeah, keeping them together at the seams sometimes, it feels. But this time, Seized chomping at the bit to go down Banana, saying, all right, Guardian, if you really are adamant to do this, I'll do it myself. But so I'm going to back away.
And now this is the setup that, you know, that's a little bit scary now, because Flamey's all alone over in Banana. It was smoked off for him, and oh, nice shot from Device. Takes out Guardian. They did have a fourth member here, though, because Flamey's playing it solo. But a minute left on the clock. TQM has the entire map open to him. And Seized is going to have to come up big again.
So much pressure on one man is not the one you expect half the time here, and Device is still waiting for this player to be present.
Seize has a timer on this play. This smoke is going to clear at some point, and then he's got to make his move, and there it is. He slides out, and Device still patiently waiting. So much time on the clock, you can do that, but a nice pop flash. Look at Zeus. Sprays down two. Knows there's a third in Boiler. Can he get away? He's low on HP. Picks up the op, and he gets it. Zeus being the hero this round, and he's going for more. He's going for a fourth kill, but he can't find it. Cajun eventually ends it.
It's got to be picked up by the rest, and Flamey comes over. And suddenly, Na'Vi find their voices, but my word, this is a dangerous matchup for both. The swings and roundabouts in these rounds are just unpredictable.
That's just unreal. What a play from Zeus. Hey, that's the thing, too, because it's, you know, you're in a 5-on-3 with 50 seconds left. If you just sit back, TQM's going to pick you apart. So Na'Vi's just saying, let's go aggressive. Here's a flash, Zeus. Do what you can with it. And he's a monster.
And until that point, Device did everything he could there. He got the opening pick. You know, he went off the back. He got the second player. And then, you know, it must be frustrating. We said, like, guys, can one of you help me out at the moment? Like, come on. And now, suddenly, we're back onto these pistols. No deagles this time. No tech nines. Nothing like that. MAC-10 being passed from body to body at this point, as C's going to find Cajun, leaving 3 alive and only Zipniks with that P250.
Zeus is about to get pushed upon. This is a small choke point that he can spray down, but now he knows there's a couple people in halls as well. He's got a teammate backing him up with a nice crossfire. And Guardian and Zeus, they just hold strong, and it's just down to Dupree, and he gets tapped away by Zeus. So 7-6 now. Na'Vi just barely holding on to this lead.
See, the thing is that, you know, some of these rounds from Na'Vi have been kind of here, there, and everywhere, a little bit kind of shaky, but in the day, it was a lot worse at the start. So they've actually brought this back up to something they can work with. They're not a bad T-sided team, but, you know, overall, this is still a very hard scoreline for them to turn around once they get towards that T-side. But still, back into this round, it's Dupree just with the Tech Nine and the utility. Everyone else relatively well set here, but already a bit of a boost there towards Banana to give them a little bit of a glimmer of maybe what's been going on, but it doesn't seem as though they're aware of this. And Flamey can actually take the fight towards Device. That might have been an error if we've ever seen one. As now, it's going to be having down to the likes of Guardian to pick up the slack. And I think he might have seen the gun coming through by Boiler then. And I think he's got an idea of what's coming his way.
Yeah, he definitely felt some sort of pressure. You could see him, you know, glance over there and then just fall away safely. So 4-on-4, excuse me, as Guardian has picked up a kill. TQM not really committed anywhere on the map. Smoke and a flash up mid towards the wrap side, and it's going to be Zipniks all on his own to push up here. Zeus sees him. Can't land that shot, but Zipniks still not committing. And finally he does it. Slides out, gets that kill, and he can't even get traded. Two members are going to get very, very close to his position from Na'Vi, but they're just going to fall away now.
But it's still Seized. It has to be Seized. Three players on Banana. If he can do this again, he has been the saving grace. And look at these guys waiting so patiently on the other side of the smoke. If only he knew. He steps away. The flash comes out. They're spraying into it. He's got a chance here. They line up again, and Seize gets two. But it's down to a 2v2 here. But this round is not over now.
It's just one more time. Seez brings him back into this round. Now Guardian's already here. Zipnix isn't even in the bomb site with the bomb yet, so it can't get planted. He's low on HP as well. Dupree, he's got to cover his mate very, very well here. And here comes Guardian to swing out. Can't land that shot, though.
It all looked a little possible. If maybe Guardian had hit that one, but now it's Edward's turn. 1v2, he's got a kit. Zipnix is low. But Zipnix holding a great little off angle then. Not going to be able to do anything from that Edward. It's Zipnix to close it down. But again, these rounds are getting closer and closer.
Yeah, this is just very, very back and forth at the moment. Going to be a strong buy, though, for NaVi into this round. I can't believe Seized one more time. Like, this play is almost just amazing with the triple kill that Dupree finally figures out where he is. It almost seemed like TQM saw him at some point out of the edge
Did
of the smoke.
Flamey just buy an orb?
Looks like it. All right. We're going to see what he's got with it. He's got to do something. Last round of the half. No money left to rebuy anything.
That spot kind of makes sense, though, to be fair. Because, well, sense is a strong word. All right. It's here. We'll embrace it for now. May have been a misbuy, but maybe Flamey's just, you know, secretly been working on the org skills. Still, let's see what can happen. CajunBee's the one holding close. This could be the problem, and actually Seez does get caught up. Zeus will pick up the slack there, though, so trades it out one for one.
Yeah, pretty nice bait and switch set up by Device and Cajun there over in Banana. You know, maybe wanted a little bit more out of them. Either way, one for one, so they've thinned out the defense, but there's still three members of this A site. Flamey's going to be there alone. There's a crack in the smoke. Device probably not expecting that, but Zipnix is there to equalize things once again, and that's the B defender, but Edward is just going to mow things down over at A.
As much as the org didn't have a presence, it certainly did some work, at least finding out the information. But now Dupree is left in the 1v2, but Zeus came around the back from quad and closed it down on the half. But a very close scoreline between these two, and maybe not what NaVi would be wanting, especially on that CT side. 8-7, it's still a very tough, you know, matchup now going into this T side.
And this is the thing, because, you know, this is a great half by TQM in terms of their scoreline, but you got to feel NaVi, once they eventually got all the money they needed, they really dominated, you know, most of this half. It's just those first five rounds for TQM.
Round six was when NaVi eventually got the AWP into the hand of Guardian. Now, he hasn't been making the biggest of impacts, but it was certainly, again, whether it's a mental thing, where it's a confidence thing, where it's how they play it, they always seem to start picking up a couple of rounds off the back of it. I don't understand how, but it's just how it goes. He didn't even have the biggest of halves in comparison to some of the others. You know, Seized was the man, constantly getting these, you know, 3Ks, these 2Ks, just spraying down, controlling it well. And he's been the man at the forefront this time.
Yeah, he's definitely had, you know, the biggest impact. We even saw Zeus have one huge round. Guardian had that huge 4K over at the B bomb site. But, you know, on the other side, it's Zipnix once again showing up. 16-9 for him. He's been playing lights out today.
It's a perfect time to start playing well as well. I want to see what he can achieve on the CT side, bearing in mind it was his CT side on train that was the, I guess, the really impressive part. He did well on his T as well, but, you know, his CT side play was just second to none, and he was kind of playing that, not necessarily solo side, but he was on B alone pretty much at the most of that part and was doing so well from it. So he can maybe find some of that coming into this half. We'll find out, but of course we are just waiting for players to get themselves comfortable and get one started back up. But now we've seen the first half. We've seen, you know, how these two have come out, you know, after the small little break in between the first map. Are you still thinking this may be a third map, or do you think this is a two and done?
Well, I'm still thinking. I said TQM was going to win this.
Oh, you said the 2-0. Yeah. The others, you had hope.
It was that wacky, crazy desk. I thought that NaVi was going to come out fired up, I believe they
Things
said.
Things do get a little weird on that couch, I'm not going to lie.
A little too many jalapeno poppers for Fifth Laren today.
I just see the grin. You know what I mean? I'd see everyone's like, look over like, why are you going to say that? Why are you going to be that guy right now?
Bring it.
Oh, don't. You've got so much to lose. Like, when I saw that, yesterday for lunch we had cupcakes, and I was like, one of these, if this goes near Moses' face, someone will do the little slap up.
I've actually learned not to eat around Anders whatsoever.
You made a right choice.
Impossible. I can't do it ever again.
But still, let's focus in on this game. We'll come back to our Cream and Moses a little later on. But it will be TQM on the CT side here, and of course NaVi on the T side, and we'll be seeing Flamey the raid boss this time, and CajunBee's got a bit of an ordeal ahead of him.
Yeah, Flamey's going to win that one. He's brought very, very low, but a good start. No rotations from the B bomb site for TQM until now, when Device spots a lot coming up mid. So now, actually, the TQM's just going to push forward, but Dupree gets that opening kill, buys a little bit of time, clears out halls as well. He knows no one's there. Device with the kill on Rapside. Can he get a second one? He's so low, but he can't finish it up.
What?
But a TK from Zeus. Oh, that's crippling.
That's absolutely devastating right now. There's only two of them alive, but okay, bomb is down at least. And Flamey's still kicking. Zeus making up for the bit of an error he made, but it's left Kerrigan in a 1v2. Now suddenly, TQM had the opportunity, should I say. And then I'll just let that slip, but no! Kerrigan comes back in with the 5-7 and locks it down. But that was a sloppy round from both sides, let's be honest. Some real errors coming through then.
Yeah, really unfortunate. I mean, Zeus knows there's fighting over at Rapside, know exactly where he is, but he's coming through a smoke, and he just comes through, you know, going for that final kill, not aware that Seize was, like, just that the timing of that kill came in was really unfortunate. Not really even a mistake by Zeus, just kind of unfortunate circumstances. Yeah. But either way, had an advantage, NaVi did, and it's a really brilliant 1-on-2 to win for Kerrigan.
Perfectly well done for him. He's going straight in for the M4 here, no messing around. He's a man who often does go for the SMGs or something a little lighter. He will switch up, at least to the Famous here, drop that out for Zipnix, and I guess you can't really blame him. Zipnix has been having the game of his life at the moment with these rifles. Give him one to work with. Device with a little quick peek down toward mid. Not going to be seeing anything too quick at the moment, but we are going to be seeing the rifle in the hand of Guardian here as well, and the Tech Knight's coming out to play.
A very, very aggressive buy into the second round. This is just that thing. They don't want TQM to build up too much money in these first rounds, so they're going for it here. They're going to try and steal it right back. They have two smokes. They have four flashbangs to work with. They have plenty of utility here. And once again, it's all on Guardian's shoulders. This time not with an AWP, but it's on his shoulders to get the opening pick. And he's going to find it over the top of the smoke just as it fades a little bit.
And they know that smoke came in from the other side of the site. They know that Kerrigan is all alone here, but he's playing it to an absolute T. And again, Edward's going to find Seize. This time, like, how many team kills do you want, NaVi? They're so just fired up right now. They're just going wild. So 3v3, this has kept things now available for TQM. Edward's going to make up for it again. Takes down Device, back to a 2v2.
Pretty incredible, but now the arsenal's in the favor of NaVi. They have two rifles to work with, M4 and an AK, but Dupree's just going to run up and grab that kill. They know exactly where he is, but he gets away. 22 HP down to a 1-on-1, 30 seconds left, and Guardian's just going to stick the plant. Dupree's at a new angle, but Guardian's ready for it, and he's going to win that. So NaVi right back onto it. He starts the round, and he ends it 9-8 for NaVi.
I want to watch these team kills back. It was just, I guess, the timing of it all
again.
Yeah,
it's another just really unfortunate circumstance.
And I'm surprised that got as close as it did. The bomb was actually yet to go down by that point, and of course, just one of them being called off a little there. But we are going to be seeing a lot of four smokes, 5-7s, P250s. Okay, let's see what they can do with this.
Usually what this indicates is that they're going to, you know, this usually is like an A stack, and you have the four smokes to just bomb over from rap side over towards B, so you try and funnel your opponents in towards that A bomb site, or you can just, you know, throw all four in the A ramp and try and funnel them towards B. You kind of get to pick which one you have with all these smokes. But TQM trying to make, you know, a little bit of investment could be a huge payoff for him.
I know Anders would be a happy boy seeing this, even just the lighter investments into these rounds. He always likes to see whether it's a smoke, a nade, flash, something. Make a lot of difference. And it is buying a little bit of time here. It's certainly keeping NaVi humble in these rounds. Another smoke will be put down here. You see one put back down towards possibly pit, and now TQM are out.
Yeah, and as they've used all their smokes, they've actually rotated back towards the B bomb set. It's only Dupree over here in A halls, but NaVi, I mean, they're just staying strong to this A hit. They want to take bracket control, see what they find.
So Dupree's going to be a man hearing this coming his way. He does have that 5-7 again, quite deadly before. Did have the vertical advantage for a second then, but Edward just plows through, and the SMGs will, well, the SMG, should I say, have seized. Could have a whale of a time here, just building up the bank, but big stack up against him.
Yeah, and Seize just runs out of bullets, but they're still fighting. But NaVi, like I said, not going to fall for it. Nice information gathered by Seize. He does find at least two there. Now he knows there's a third, so easy plant in that A bomb site. It's going to be just a very, very simple end of this round for NaVi.
Well played out by them as well. And, you know, a team that doesn't often need to be reminded of, you know, taking the side of caution to these rounds. They certainly do this within their bread and butter play. So see it paying dividend at this point. 10-8 now. Again, though, question mark. A little light for cash. Got the CZs, P250s again. Not much to be working with in this one.
No, not at all. And this is just going to put a lot onto that next round. It's that situation where they're going to be the ones who have to take it right back. I mean, you saw NaVi lose the first gun run in the first half. And, I mean, just provides so much if you can get started early up on this map. So Navi's done a really good job of stealing it away despite losing the pistol round. But TQM are going to have a tall task in this next round.
Yeah, and the kind of tip of the spear being seized at the moment, looking for these kills with the Mag Daddy at this point. And on the other side, you can see that TQM are trying to push up real close with those pistols, try and get some damage done as close as possible, but it's always going to be difficult with absolutely no armor, of course. The CZ may have a shot at it this time, and being quite cautious as to where they're playing at this point.
It's going to be up towards Cajun or Dupree over towards the A bomb site to maybe try and find an initial kill, but Dupree just rotated off over towards B, where there's a commit from C's. He's all the way in, trying to find any kind of intel, but meanwhile, Edward doing some work at the A bomb site, so they're about to see that the other side of the map is completely clear. It's just the bomb is all the way back, so Kerrigan gets that kill. Now goes down, and now there's one player rotating over. Dupree, if he can catch the bomb off guard coming back up, that would be incredible. That could end things, but he's not aware of it. But Edward's still alone with the bomb. He's still in a lot of trouble.
And he knows it. He's trying to turn the flash, but Flamey helps him out as well, and suddenly NaVi pull it back in at the hands of Flamey, but again, so close to these rounds being absolutely devastating. You can see the air of caution they're all taking. So scared of an angle, a corner, something where maybe Device was hiding, but he has managed to stay alive for now. Keep hold of this rifle. But the difference a kill can make at this point, just recovering that rifle off the back of it as well, and suddenly, that bomb being left down in the bottom banana became one of the biggest issues Navi's had to face.
Yeah, that was really scary. There are a couple of opportunities there if TQM just looks the right way at the right time, or if they push down B a little bit faster, they can punish that very much. But Navi's going to get away with it. Device is even going to save this AK. You can see Navi's not too keen on, you know, dedicating a lot of bodies towards this chase, towards the hunt, you know, because if they lose one or two more guys, all of a sudden this is far too expensive of a round.
There we go. Three for NaVi staying alive. Device, of course, just about keeping hold of that rifle. And we will be seeing the scoreline now at 11-8. Getting a little further in front now, NaVi. But this is the buy coming out from TQM. This is when, as you said, these are the big rounds. These are the ones that they need to put on the board to keep this one going anywhere near their favor.
Yeah, this first gun round is just so crucial for the CT sides. Even despite the fact that, you know, they won pistol and then lost afterwards, still this first gun round is massively important. Device has the ADVP. He opens up on a seize. With that kill now, they can just fall back.
And it looks like that's pretty much what they're doing. Device took a little bit of damage off the back of that, but then again, who cares? He got the opener off the back of that, and he's going to be just fine. Guardian going to clear out the close corner. Molly's going to be put through. Navi's actually looking quite quick at trying to take action towards Banana here, but slow things down again. Waited out. There's still a lot of smokes to be put down over by the TQM side, so they can buy a hell of a lot more time at this point. I don't see exactly where NaVi want to take themselves this time.
I mean, just like true NaVi fashion, this is just going to slow down. They're going to wait out these smokes. There's still two more in the arsenal of TQM, so I'd be surprised if NaVi actually even tried to execute through them. But still, they don't feel any pressure at B, and no smoke is laid down on that B choke point, but Navi's not moving up whatsoever. Now one finally gets deployed, about 45 seconds, and Cajun has the last one. He's over towards the A bomb site, so that's not going to be helpful because this is definitely going to be a late round B hit for NaVi. They have Edward in position to try and flank, try and pinch, cause any kind of distraction over towards A.
And he's done well. He's going to buy time, slow down those three players. It's down to the two on the site. Guardian straight away diving in with the rifle. Zipnix just crouched down by the statue itself, or at least on the little monument in the middle there. But it's Kerrigan at the back lines, falling back to Nubox. Already finding Zeus, expecting the close push-up from Edward. Now they know he's here. These guys are going to come pouring through, but the bomb is down. There's only two players left for NaVi.
Yeah, Edward's got to win this fight over towards Banana, and he can't do it. Dupree drops him. There is a kit on Device, so they can take their time with this retake, despite only having one flashbang to work with. That off is what's really going to start pinning Flamey down, but they line up 4-2 for him. And it's down, just down to a 1-on-1 with Dupree, and Flamey's going to win it. What an incredible round. Heartbreaking for TQM.
That's a smile of why would you ever line up for Flamey? Why give that man any other opportunities? Everything until that moment was looking like, okay, TQM still got this to hand. They're still doing okay. But then Flamey with the lockdown, this last kill as well.
That's incredible. That is so crushing for TQM to have played it. Once again, another really, really well-played round from them, and it just kind of collapses in the end. But a 1-on-3 from Flamey. Now we've seen so many players step it up for NaVi. Everyone seems to be contributing when they're called upon.
Do you remember that third map you said wasn't going to happen?
Yeah. I'm starting to see it in my nightmares.
It would be Mirage if it does come that far. But still, it's 12-8, almost said 9, because that last round. 12-8 here, but not over yet. Device can be picking the AWP back up here. Not sure of his money right now. Does he just equal out at the moment, or maybe just an investment? But it really doesn't pay off at all.
Yeah, no, it's just kind of a desperation buy. He has the money for it, and he's like, maybe I can get two picks. You know, lighten things up. The pistols can clean things out, but, you know, we have to start winning. You know, we can't let this get too far out of control, and it's actually going to get there until Dupree. He slows things down just a little bit, but everyone else is just getting wrecked by Edward and Guardian.
Yeah, it's looking a little bit brutal here. Nice shot from Kerrigan, but for absolutely nothing by this point. And it does mean there will be an AWP more than likely available here for Guardian if he fancies it coming into the next round for free at this point. And Zipnix just looking for exits, looking for anything at this point because, you know, nothing's really been going their way. And Edward's been guarding where that AWP got dropped here. And you can see that TQM are desperate to get something back in their hands, but I doubt they're going to find anything at this point.
Yeah, I mean, that investment by Device in this round just goes to show. Edward, you sneaky man. Finds the AWP, now Zipnix just waiting for Guardian to come through the smoke is going to punish him. So there is an AK-47, one behind him, and he's not prepared for it, so Seize is going to end it. But that investment by Device, I mean, that just goes to show you how desperately counter-terrorist teams on this map want, like, they can't let this slip away. They can't let the terrorist team get so many rounds so early. Now Navi's completely in control of the economy for the rest of the half. I mean, they had to go for something. They had to take a risk at a certain point.
Risky play, I guess, but it certainly hasn't paid off. This has given Na'Vi more than a decent run towards that end scoreline now. 13-8, they've got a good economy built up here, and their T-side performance has been looking substantially better than their CT side. Let's be very clear about this one. They were looking a little shaky overall, but this has kind of kept things very much alive here into map two. Map one was a victory for TQM over on train. Map two is looking like maybe this could be Na'Vi's. We might finally get that third map we've been looking for all this time, but still, not there yet. A couple more rounds to go, and a slow round again from Na'Vi.
Yeah, TQM with a setup that not a lot of quick rotations to either bombsite. Two players dedicated in B, and three players for TQM dedicated very far into the A bombsite, over by pit. All three members, one on balcony, one pushed up in pit, you know. These guys cannot get over towards that B bomb site very quickly, so a lot of pressure is going to be put on Kerrigan and Zipnix if they get executed upon.
Pressure plenty might be applied very soon. And a nice little boost up here towards the top of quad, and we have to see that if it is just Edward. Oh my word, Edward with the adjustment then just appears right up and over. Dupree's head just gets taken clean off as Seize now wants a little bit of a bite at the cherry as well, but Kerrigan says no. But Zipnix has got his back here. Guardian with a slow creep towards the side doesn't get a chance, and it looks like, for now, I hate to say it, but TQM finally lock it down. And it's going to be Zipnix at the helm again, keeping these boys in this game.
Just once again, Zipnix is just... he came to play today so well, and that, what a defense from them. I mean, that both players get spotted by that first the first Na'Vi member who enters that bomb site. One's at first oranges, one's at second. So, you know, they're just kind of trying to juggle the aggression a little bit, peek with some flashbangs, and it's really, really well done by them. But the shots that Zipnix just hit are incredible. He's top fragging for TQM. He's at 21-15. The next closest is Dupree with 14. The rest of them down at about 11-12.
And not many men will survive an attempt from Guardian like that, but you can see he's just playing so, so well there. Again, keeping things possibly, you know, not over for TQM. Let's be very honest here. If that round went to Na'Vi, it was looking like it was almost, you know, let's think about map three, but still 13-9, TQM back into this Device. Oh, Zipnix holding this angle. Guardian there gonna back away from it actually, and Zipnix gonna back off as well, but gonna deny complete control of Banana early on to Na'Vi, but they can still build up towards it slowly into this. Na'Vi again taking apps control as well.
Yep, just taking control of things, just making sure there's no aggression. So when they eventually in these late rounds, very similar setup once again, Dupree and Device, you know, all the way over towards lane, Cajun and Pit. So no one's on the wrap side to even rotate towards the B bomb site. Very, very heavy setup on this side of the site. And it looks like this time Na'Vi's gonna come right at him.
Last time Edward absolutely destroyed Dupree. Dupree this time playing a little different. You can see Device already backing away towards side, and they are retracting very far back here. Gonna play behind the smokes, and the flash is being put down. Edward's already up, and they are gonna start lining up a little bit then. Dupree just eases off the gas pedal then, leaves Flamey still alive just through that smoke, but Device watching the push through towards CT Arch, and he just beats out Guardian on the peak then. Now Edward might look to switch up, maybe try and pick up that AWP and take it back into the hands of Na'Vi, but a deeper smoke now keeps... oh, Device, he's not even guessing. He knows they haven't pushed through towards CT Arch just yet. He can adjust around, but Zeus will be here.
He jumped over into the spotted one. That could be a wrap around him. It's got to be careful, but either way, Edward with a very nice shot, but Zeus is about to get a free kill, but not before Device has much more impact in the round. And the time is running very low, only 6 seconds left in Cajun. That might just end it.
It's done.
Bomb can't get planted. No one else from the B bomb site even needs to show up for TQM. Zeus, he gets the kill, but it's all over now, down to just one player. And Kerrigan and Zipnix survive. TQM right back into this one because the economy is so incredibly low for Na'Vi. They do have this one AK-47. They may choose to buy, but it's going to be a very dodgy buy.
Yeah, and Device has been hitting some absolute blinders in that as well. Taking out Guardian, following up perfectly even before he was able to be closed in on. So good stuff from Device. You know, we say on a regular basis he can be one of the most consistently good players, but he's, you know, not had the loudest of games. It's not been one of his, you know, big performers, but he's certainly still there. He's certainly still present. And there is no AWP this time out for Na'Vi.
That flank from Zeus could have just been...
It could have changed everything.
It could have been the clincher for that round. If he had the time to really be that slow, just, you know, he just is just one or 2 seconds late as that clock is dwindling. The rest of his teammates feel the need to pressure the site.
Yep.
And Device gets that one last kill.
Nice smoke. Timing from Device there. Going to buy a little bit of a couple of seconds for them to rotate around towards quad side or play off the back of site, but... Na'Vi not instantly working off the back of it. They have got some play towards mid now, though. It's Device watching that push through by Library. Going to adjust from last round. He's not holding the same angle here.
That last round, by the way, Device, he just eats the flashbang full force that Guardian throws, and he just shoots blind. That was just, you know, he just times it so well, the peak that Guardian's taking with that flash.
Zeus going to run the gauntlet. That's the question. Is he really going to go for this? The smoke's going to... avert Device's eyes for a second, then it will open up a couple of seconds for Na'Vi to move around here. CT Arch now becomes their territory, but Device is watching it. He's keeping control of this entire piece of this map here, while the rest of Na'Vi do start trying to make their way through quad, trying to make their way through short, but look at this. Cajun B's there, Dupree's on site. They've got a nice crossfire in play here. It's got to be Edward to try and take this one apart, dismantle it piece by piece. He does a nice little swing up, but no, Dupree's there. Cease finds Device, but that opens up CT Arch, but there's still Cajun B here. He's still buying time. 7 seconds left, down to six here. Cajun B with the closer, brilliantly done again in those final seconds, keeping TQM in this. And my God, all right, we're going to have the timeout here. The timeout of doom coming into place.
You can see Dupree in the site, gets that kill, and Cajun's just playing off of him. That's not communicated, but you can see how Cajun moves based on where Dupree is. So they actually have this setup where they're shooting at the same spot. It's so well done by Cajun to have that presence of mind to shift perfectly to make that the most effective it possibly can be. So another good hold, but another round where, I mean, Na'Vi, we know this. This every time the NLSS talks about it is they run this clock down, and every time it's just a risk, and they encounter just a little bit of, you know, a little bit of defense, and it slows everything down, and all of a sudden they only have, you know, 7 seconds to get one kill and plant the bomb, and they just end on round timer.
To remind, though, the first map they called the you know, a little bit of a pause, and it became a little bit more scary overall. And both teams have done this now. Both teams have called these timeouts and responded perfectly off the back, generally into their favor. So this one was, of course, called out, if I'm not mistaken, by Na'Vi at this point to try and, you know, make sure that TQM don't have that momentum coming back through. They don't get that confidence building. Okay, guys, we can just run this. Hell, you know, Na'Vi could just be sitting there having a good little just chill time. But from what I can see on my screens, they're definitely not just chilling out. There's a good discussion happening as I look over towards their desk.
It'll be interesting to see what they decide to buy into this round. I almost wouldn't mind seeing them pick up some utility and some armor and some upgraded pistols. Most of them are sitting between, you know, 2,500 and 3,200. So they don't have the full losing bonus, only three rounds of it. But, you know, the money for TQM is so low based on these last two rounds. And Na'Vi's got to have an idea. It's come down to two players both times. So even just getting 2 to 3 kills this round for Na'Vi could go a long way moving forward. They don't just want to hand this over. That's exactly what's going to happen for Na'Vi. They have the Tech-9s. They have some P250 smokes. There's four members with armor on the Na'Vi side, just Flamey without. Actually, and he picks it up right at the end as well.
All right, Na'Vi. Can you do it? You've had your timeout now, and mostly people have ended up actually closing. Bear in mind, Joe, TQM did this on train with just a couple of smokes and pistols, which was a little bit more shocking than most expected. But still, 13 rounds still in the pocket of Na'Vi. They are on the T side, though. The last couple have been definitely not going their way at this point. But it looks like they're going to be setting up for what's the kind of like standard smoke out towards that A side. But whether or not they commit, yet to be seen, I feel.
Yeah, smoke execute is up. Device is on wrap side. He gets flashed back. Pit is completely smoked off. There's a wall of it. And Device, he's also hiding behind smoke, but Na'Vi is just running up. And this is Device. He's got to come up huge. Gets that first kill with the M4. Gets a second one as well. He eventually does fall to Zeus, but he's done his job. He has the intel. And now even with Guardian pressing up lane, Dupree, all he has to do is stay alive. He's going to be very careful as the smoke fades. The bomb is getting planted.
Yeah, at least they've got a plan out of this, but they want more. And why not, I guess? They've got two players standing. Not recovered a gun, though. It is Guardian. It is seized. Dupree's a little low, kind of tucked in at this point, and they're being very cautious on retaking this.
Yeah, they're not pressuring him at all. They had to. They had to get him out of there. Now there's no chance into this round.
He's doing around the world. They don't know where he is. He's got to make his move, though, now. The defuse comes out. Dupree eventually checked quad, but if that was maybe planted default or maybe just on that little corner, he could have done something with that. But I guess hindsight, it's 20-20. But in the end, NaVi don't make it work. You can see Device. The thing I really like about this, he's always found this nice little gap. It's not necessarily a gap. It's something NaVi is certainly aware, because you can see Flamey trying to kind of pressure that angle. He's always being so good from that, from Device. He did it with his AWP as well earlier on, but still. Back onto the buy here. This is the big round.
I can't believe how long Dupree stayed alive in that pit without any pressure from him.
Like, it was like 15 HP, right?
Yeah, in like 15 seconds he did it. But look at this aggressive play. TQM switches things up. They're just going to push down B. Kerrigan throws a nade. He gets caught with his gut nut out, but he does so much work. Three kills for him. Now he's able to fall away and not be crippled into this round.
That is gutting if you're NaVi, because really, Kerrigan didn't know he tagged someone through the smoke so desperately. That nade was just kind of a, I hope I do some damage effort before these guys push through and kill me, because I've got like no bullets left essentially by this point. But hell, Kerrigan makes it work. And the one thing I used to really like about TSM was their play down banana. They were able to smoke down deep, do a lot of damage, and again, be able to fall back into that. But there's Flamey and there's Edward. They've got 50 seconds, they've got the bomb.
What a good change of pace by TQM to open that round up. And now it's just easy. You know, just fall back, just play your bomb sites, force NaVi to commit. Don't give anything up. So Cajun, just peeking this angle. I mean, even if he spots someone, he's not going to take that fight. He would fall back in towards the bomb site. But no one from NaVi even postures for it. They're going to head back towards the B site where, unfortunately, I mean, they got two members here. Kerrigan and Dupree is actually cheating. So they could find a one-on-one isolated in the back of the bomb site if Kerrigan misplays this. He's very low on HP.
I can imagine Kerrigan's going to try and just stay alive as long as possible, if he can. I doubt he's been spotted out at this point, but the Molly coming in, oh my god, he still gets a shot on the way through. You'll be seeing it as well, closed out by Dupree towards Flamey then, but they committed the Molly, but didn't expect anyone to just swing out of there, but this was the deciding factor.
Yeah, for Kerrigan almost, that's very fortunate timing as he throws the nade to come through the smoke. That was also coming through that smoke is NaVi. The reason why he pulls that nade out is because it's like they already have control. They got that first kill, not expecting more bodies to just jump right through it.
Right.
And you can see why it just gets punished. So 13-13 now, another buy out of NaVi, and this is crazy. Oh my god, look at how much damage is just done by nades.
Who threw those? I don't even know, like Flamey, Edward, Seized, all just like ripped to shreds?
That's insane. So another huge advantage early on for TQM.
Do you remember what we were saying, that normally it's NaVi picking up three for free almost? It's kind of going the other way around right now, and Kerrigan's just diving back in on this. Going to catch out Zeus, leaving it down to Flamey, Guardian, and Seize this time. Sure, it's not the same two as before, but still you got to be getting frustrated. And bear in mind, there's still a minute left on the board. They've not been flustered by this. Device is going to back away, flash out towards CT Arch, keep him back, buy time. Cajun Beak now peeking on it. And they know it's safe. This is really nice stuff from Question Mark so far.
Yeah, look, a nice shot from Guardian. They have to get more of that, and they do. What is happening? Guardian opens things up down to a 3-on-3, and that's done with no smokes, no flashes. He just takes the battles, and TQM all of a sudden on the back foot. But Device, he's going to give him an advantage again.
Guardian just went in dry, and it actually worked out for him. Two kills back-to-back, but Seized and Guardian now defending this plant with everything they've got, but... And CTQM dancing between those bullets. Seize actually does land one, but here we go. It's down to Guardian, the man, the myth, who did so well before. Pushed out of position. He's going to get another. That's three, but he can't get the 1v1. And time is just on Zipnix's side.
That's so scary for TQM to almost lose that round of just Guardian walking up. They only had one flashbang, so it's like you're thinking in your head, or I'm thinking in my head, how does NaVi possibly get back into this
right, with
the decimation that's occurred? And that's how. I mean, Guardian just with two amazing shots. Even Seize chimes in with one right there at the end on Device. But very scary spot to be in. Comes down to a one-on-one, and NaVi just, much the story of these last, you know, six rounds, just not able to close anything out.
Well, the pause for once not working out for NaVi here.
It almost backfired. It's almost like...
It's given TQM also like a little bit more time to think about how goddamn well they've just tried to do and just tone things up a little bit as well.
Yeah, they've just been dominant since that timeout. And that's the thing. Coming out of the timeout, they're like, all right, you want to switch things up? We're just going to push down B, put you in your place. Like, we're not letting go of this match. We're just going to win it out. So this is very, very good stuff at the end of this second half for TQM.
becoming more and more frustrating, I can imagine, for Na'Vi as well. Just like, what can we do? We've tried so much. We've done the pause. We've done the timer. We tried a little bit more aggression. Tried to speed it up here. Tried cutting through CT Arch. Hits towards B, and none of it working thus far. And some of it's been by just that little dash of aggression from Kerrigan. Or now he's got the op to play with, holding a little more of a secondary angle there. But it is Na'Vi pushing up in mid. They had some control. Back away. They're not being given free control here, and Kerrigan, he made the most of it. He already caught out C's pushing up on his own, and the bomb was heading that way.
He gets that opening pick, but there's actually been a lot of utility used for TQM in this round. But so now Na'Vi, I mean, without that player over at B, the smokes just get deployed. They can't wait that long, so they're going to pressure A one more time. But 24 seconds left on the clock. They've run it down one more time.
20 seconds to go, and Guardian's starting to warm up. Now, maybe this is what they needed, but he's going to have to start doing this again and again. And look at it, KGB is just waiting out devices there. Now, KGB just pounces, but it's flamey. 10 seconds left. Where's that bomb? He finally picks it up. It's down to 2v1, though, and surely he can't make this work.
Well, he's got to plan it in the bomb site. So now, does he have time? Does he take the risk and try and get out? Throws a smoke over towards the truck just to slow down any kind of a push. Zipnix is going to swing out and just win that battle, as he's been doing all day long. So another one-on-one battle that Zipnix wins, but Na'Vi just can't get anything going for him. Yep. And this actually pretty clever. Sorry to cut you off, but Cajun that round, Guardian, you know, the previous round, just walked up and destroyed him on balcony. So Cajun takes a little bit of a deeper angle. So Guardian looks there again to go for that very same kill, and like little does he know, Cajun is virtually in the same spot, just a little bit deeper, so Guardian can't see him, and he ends up getting some crucial kill.
And I realize that then if you hold that deeper angle, you have to really commit out as well. You can't just kind of dance on the edge of it. You have to be fully out, and the crossbow is paying off already, let alone when you do that sort of play. But look at this across the board. So much great individual stuff coming out from these guys. You know, it was a quiet game at the start for Device, and that nade, not, oh, okay, that one did. That one hurt a little more, and now suddenly Na'Vi are looking a little worse for wear. Zipnix caught a glimpse, and that's all he needs. Perfect flash slows him down. Molly into place, and again, Na'Vi are just controlled from start to finish here.
Yeah, but you can see Na'Vi, you know, feeling the pressure. They have no map control. They have no presence anywhere else, so this allows a third member of TQM to rotate over towards the B bomb site.
Oh,
Na'Vi didn't
go.
Take control of A halls.
They're going for this, so Na'Vi going straight through here, right into the eyes of Zipnix. That's two. He looks for more. He can't get it, but already on the side, you can see backup en route. Na'Vi, they're doing what they can. They're fighting dirty, but it's not paying out. It's a 2v1. Guardian's got 2 HP. 50 seconds left. He knows where Dupree is. This round will take question mark through. This will be game over for Na'Vi into this matchup at least. But Guardian looking for a chance, a glimmer of hope for Dupree. Just sitting so, so patiently. He just spotted him out. They know exactly where he is. And piece by piece is becoming less and less likely for Guardian.
He's got time to work with, but 2 HP just can't make a single mistake. Fortunately, Device has the AWP. It's Dupree he's got to worry about when he goes for this plant. He's got nothing. He's got to land a nice shot, but Dupree, just a nice tap through the corner of the wall, knows the positioning. And TQM, they just, at a certain point, they win one round and they take complete control of this match.
It was a spiraling effect there because Na'Vi were building back in. They were starting to look deadly, and you saw even Guardian starting to, you know, pick up some real performance with the rifle. You know, Seized had a great little bit of a performance himself, but overall, Zipnix has to be the man of the match in this one for me. You know,
We
saw some great plays coming out from the likes of Device as per usual. I think someone just fell off the stage, but, you know, please don't die while we're still casting. Do it off air so, you know, we don't get sued. But still, at the moment, these guys, you've got to say it for TQM, starting to look like a team who's actually starting to enjoy themselves again, starting to look like they're having fun with it and just still looking deadly.
Yeah, I mean, the way they showed up today from train on was just really, really good. And yeah, easily MVP of that matchup is Zipnix. What an impact he had. Device also, you know, on that CT side. Everyone really, and even, I mean, even the Na'Vi players, we always talk about who's going to show up outside of Guardian. And this time it was everyone had a round or two here and there.
It definitely did. It just seemed as though Na'Vi kind of just ran out of steam a little bit and towards the kind of later throws of that matchup. And even with that pause coming in, it just didn't pay off like it normally does.
That's Inferno for you, because you could see once you know, in the first half, TSM won those first five, and once Na'Vi got control of the economy on the CT side, you know, they won like eight of the next 10 rounds. And then the same thing happened when TSM, you know, they were a little bit beat up early on, and once they eventually won one and got control of the economy, they just closed out the half. So Inferno, reliant on the CT economy.
I think a massive factor that did kind of decide some of the outcomes in that matchup, but let's hear it from the players themselves over on the stage with Stagekist.
Stageokist, I think that's a new one. I like that. How are you doing, Kerrigan? I'm doing fine. I'm doing fine.
Good. You guys could almost be called Quest Denmark now, because you guys, Denmark's on a quest to the finals. You guys looked pretty emphatic in that game. A little bit more organized than yesterday. How did you guys feel? We'll get into the details, but how did that feel overall as a team chemistry?
I think everybody was upset about our loss in EM San Jose against NaVi. Because we beat so differently, we had some problems back then after coming home from vacation. So basically we tried to do another approach and play a train instead of a couple that pick. So I think all in all, I think we did a good job today. I'm proud of my guys, very good communication, and Cyber's just stepping up all the whole game. So it's amazing when people have good performances.
Yeah, his transformation has been very impressive over the last few months since you guys, as Device said yesterday, sat him down about, you know, stepping up individually. Were you a bit surprised NaVi picked Train? That was a map that they struggled on previously. They've been doing better. You guys were really good on it for a while, though, arguably the best in the world. You guys used to beat, I think, VP three times in a row.
I think NaVi is one of the best teams on Train, in my opinion, after practice or watching their wrestles. I mean, I wasn't surprised. I kind of knew they would pick Train since that's what we banned last time. So I kind of knew that they had to do it this time because they felt like, okay, maybe they're not that confident on the map. Apparently, people think we're very good on Train. I think it's more like we got some fake confidence, in my opinion, beating Virtus Pro three times at PGL or something like this. And then when we finally believed in our map, Train, we picked it versus NIP at the Major and completely got smashed on the map. So I think it's like when you pick the map, you feel like you have to win it. Maybe they get some fake confidence on the map. Just like Inferno was, I think we're behind 13-8, so we had to call back into the game. So I think it's all in all, NaVi is one of the best teams on Train as well.
Yeah, and that's a good segue to Inferno. Before we get there, though, there's one thing I do want to ask about on Train, because you guys played a little bit more aggressive than normal. You guys used your utilities, and I know Cajun B said shutting down Guardian was big, but use your utilities to get map control and then played really forward, which shut them down on, you know, their really quick take style. Was that something you guys talked about specifically against NaVi?
I don't think specifically. Basically, I have been playing the mid control for, like, past half year, and people figured out in the end how I played that middle area. So I could feel like how we got anti-strated on Train after we beat some teams there, and that's why I have to hold Ellie right now. So we're trying to get different players to play different styles, and something that pays off, that didn't pay off that good at against NIP at the Major, because we didn't feel like it was the right meet on the map at that moment. But I feel like Train is becoming better and better for us after the practices we had and the talks about the map, instead of like shying away from it, just let it be in the pool. If people want to play it, we just play it then.
And I love that you talk about Change too, because you were really good in that position. Cajun was there today. You had you and Zipix, or Zipnix, whatever, you let me know, inside Alley. You guys went back to that, but you played Device Dupree there occasionally when you get stale. Okay, Inferno, you said it. Good T side, but you did get kind of caught off guard early on. What was talked about in that timeout?
When did we make the timeout?
I think you were behind 13-8, I think it was, or 9?
I think we just felt like many of the rounds, the Riverman actually threw away. There was a 2-1-4 situation on B. We basically made the right calls, right, doing the right things, but didn't close it out in a 3-1. And that basically sets your mind, like, how do we need to talk? Do we just need to calm down, play the same as we did, and just, like, let the rounds unfold in our events instead of letting them get in advanced positions? So I think we just talked about keeping ourselves calm and doing what we feel is, like, the right thing. And I think we played very good. We had Cypress had amazing rounds and B were able to hobble together with me, and, like, he shot, like, 3 or 4 guys. So I just think people stepped up when they had to, and I felt like NaVi could feel the pressure. And especially on T Inferno, if you can't get into good position, it's very hard for the enemies or yourself to put in advantages on Inferno, because it makes it very hard to play T side there, in my opinion.
Mm-hmm. Well, you guys did have a good T side. Great game overall. I'd say now you just basically get to sit back and rest. You know that, like Envious, you guys have moved on to the semifinal. I guess there's obviously still a deciding match tomorrow, but who would you rather play in that semifinal at this point in time from the crossover position in the other group?
I think it doesn't matter for us. I feel like Fnatic Envy is still hard opponents for us. I mean, in kind of slump, so face.
Well, it would be, just to clarify, I know I pulled the mic from you. Envious is already through, so you wouldn't have to play them until the final. Yeah, so it would be Fnatic, or at this point in time, I think, who else is in that group? Liquid. Conquest and Liquid, yeah.
I think we'll face Fnatic. If they don't, it's a big disappointment, in my opinion. So basically, we want some revenge from the Fnatic tournament we had, where we also crashed out 3SK, stuff like that. So I think it's good for us to play a team who's, where we actually can perform better. I feel like we have played a lot of matches lately where we're actually big favorites and not able to deliver because of the slump period. So I think a good day today with 2-0, 2x2-0 in the group stage, make us feel more confident, and maybe that'll be able to beat Fnatic tomorrow, I think, or whoever we will meet.
All right, well, I'll leave it at that. Thank you so much. Great game, great interview, lots of insight. And with that, I'm sure the desk has lots to say about it. And of course, to lead that desk, as Mama Rosa, the makeup artist, likes to call him, it's Tony the Tiger.
Thanks very much, Sudoku-ist. Yeah, there's a story behind that one. I will explain that a little later on, maybe. But for now, we need to talk and address that game in hand and the game in question. That was an interesting one from the get-go, primarily because I was so unwilling to admit that it was Guardian plus four. However, there was so much evidence on Inferno where it was... I mean, he was being more productive and... aggressive with the rifle. I mean, it was two instances at the top of my list where he was actually getting the entry frag with an AK ahead of the rest of his team, even when the sniper wasn't available. And he was definitely someone that I want to discuss just quite quickly before we talk about the man, the great Dane, Zipnix.
Well, I kind of disagree with the whole NaVi thing, because I think on their CT side, they were down 5-0.
Yep.
There was a bunch of players from NaVi that actually showed up. You have Cease with the triple kill, make it 5-1. You have the Flame Instant where he clutches 1-on-3, you know. Guardian with the 4-kill onto Banana. I mean, they did show up. It's just at the end of their... When you notice that XTSM does a really good job in holding back NaVi on their slow executes, then you saw the same thing here on Inferno, where they do a really good job in not wasting nades too early in the rounds, and then by the time the NaVi wants to execute, they have all the nades still there, and then you run out of time. And I called it yesterday, I think, actually, for NaVi, that Inferno is the map that they run out of time the most on.
Yeah.
It's already a very slow map, but then add in the, you know, NaVi's strategies as well, where they're really slow, you're just going to have a hard time. Like, you need to switch it up a little bit.
Yeah.
You did see that one approach. That's probably what you're referring to. When they, right after the timeout, there was Nico. Don't mind that too much. Next round, next weapon round after that, they decided to go fast Banana. And that's where you see the little tendency there, where Guardian rushes through the smoke. Then he's all alone. He ends up dying. And then the others like fall a little bit behind. Mm-hmm. And then they run through the smoke as well. Ends up killing two more. And then, you know, the round is already over then.
This is the hero mentality. This is the problem, is when sometimes, you know, you get that player who feels like he is the star, and I have to do it, right? It has to be me, right? And, you know, you can see how Kenny had that with Titan, and he would walk in and, you know, drop amazing score lines. But when the team starts to fall behind, you can look and you see this player just keep trying to make the plays, trying to crack it open, because I don't know if it's like, you know, he's frustrated with the team, like not getting in there and doing it for him, or he feels like it's all on him, like he's the guy who has to actually get the kill for anything to happen. But, yeah, Guardian, I mean, it's still, you know, Inferno, once it's really started to go south, you start to see him peak more, take more risks, go through smokes, really try and take the fight to TSM. To TQM. Only problem is right here, right? You know, like,
this is like a beautiful combination.
This was just Kerrigan just obliterating them. I mean, that's just pain right there. It was pretty much already done. NaVi had defeated themselves mentally by then.
Yeah.
Because we see them go for a few more plays after that, and it's just disjointed. It's just one guy running through, and then another guy, and then, you know, three other guys coming in afterwards, and it's just never really that cohesive unit where they just go boom into TQM and blow them up.
Yeah, I mean, overall, we see right from the beginning, NaVi start to make some good progress. They start to get themselves back into the game, but then they start to change things up a little bit. They take it a lot slower. The timer starts running down lower and lower, and the members of XTSM start to abuse that. I think you touched on it again. The nades was a pretty big issue here. They weren't really trying to make any more aggressive moves at the beginning of the round. They would hold it back and just try to do this one big explosion play, and it would never work out because XTSM would always have a great setup for it. And we constantly saw these plays on both sites where they had setups for it and were constantly able to hold, despite how many people from NaVi were trying to push into the site at once.
I'm going to give it all to Zipnix.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, that's the big point to make.
Zipnix just, in two maps, wrecked NaVi. Just wrecked them. Like, he was buying, like, head and shoulders above everybody else. Device came back, you know, as far as frags are concerned, Device came back and, you know, contested Zip for the top spot on train. But, like, all the high-impact frags, all the clutch rounds, like, the big rounds, the impact rounds. Where did this guy come from? Like,
well,
he's supposed to be like the support player, like the guy who's there to set it up for Device, for Dupree, for Cajun, for Kerrigan. No, he's just like, step aside, boys.
Do you know what it is?
It's my time now. boom, boom, and just it, like
is the point you made. You said that XTSM, now TQM, the outliers, where they don't have this one or two men squadron of fraggers and stars. You're like, oh, you know, there's about four members. You were like, oh, there's about four, leaving out Zipnix. You were like, hang on a second, excuse me, there's all five of us here. And he to kind of demonstrate to you that there is in fact a full all-star five-man Danish squad, and he's done so in an incredible fashion.
He had, it feels like, most of the key rounds that really kept TQM in this best of three. Honestly, because NaVi, a lot of them were doing well.
Yeah.
Zipnix, I mean, you really have to give it to him in this series, I think.
Yeah, I mean, clutch situations when they're on force buys, when just in general, like, he was really, really good this series.
Just playing the pit.
I mean, yeah.
This is the round that just completely shrecked NaVi as well.
Yeah, that was the eco. He ends up killing one more, right? And he ends up getting a rifle, and then he just ends up winning the round. You saw it again and again, and like, yeah, he was superb this whole matchup versus NaVi.
We did, however, see some prominent plays from KJMB as well from Pit. I think that's something that I wanted to highlight, just because he was actually, because of how slow NaVi play, because we were down to 20 seconds, like on numerous occasions on their T side, by the time that you do come in and they weren't checking Balcon, they weren't checking Pit, by the time that he comes down to that, KJMB just laughs, because he plays the time so beautifully with those last, like he was getting 2-3 frags towards the end of rounds on A, and it was very nice to watch. And
on the pit, it wasn't until Guardian came in and they finally caught on that he was playing Balcony every single time, pretty
exactly.
much.
Exactly.
Do we have it here? No, Guardian got picked off on that round.
This is the round.
Zeus.
He's in pit here.
Ah, this is where he hears it.
They fast forwarded, but he ends up killing the bomb planter. They don't have enough time to actually plant, and you saw that again. You saw that again and again for NaVi, because they're a little bit too slow. I mean, the rounds work. That's why, like, for example, if you play the same kind of scenario next week when you have the new patch, then yeah, this will be, they'll have, you know, 10 more seconds to work with planning the bomb.
Yeah,
right?
But Guardian had to say about the timers, though, he was not a fan of them, despite maybe favoring some of NaVi's rounds.
Yeah, no, it's a mixed thing, because Starix, it's fun to talk with Starix, actually, because Starix is like, I don't really care about the time. I'm like, of course you would say that, you know, more time for you is good. But for him, he's just like, I'm more concerned about the bomb. The bomb timer being extended by 5 seconds. Basically, everybody gets a kit, because you don't need to buy a kit anymore. So
Touché. You
can just do what you want, really. You get an extra smoke nade, you get an extra two flashes, whatever. You don't need to prioritize that kit anymore. So it actually really messes the economy, because now the CTs can actually afford to have more nades than they would otherwise, because one guy should be, you know, taking that hit to get the kit, or
that kind
right?
of like what is essentially CT side, it just gets enhanced.
I mean, we really haven't discussed the patch much at all, though. You know,
no,
so it's just
right? I mean, we've left it because we assumed there was going to be some immediate changes in text. We didn't want to kind of like break it apart, and then all of a sudden that's immediately rekindled.
I guess it's also like because we don't. I mean, this is. I'm sure all of you guys have caught on by now, but this is being played on the old version of the game, and so you know, should we be delving into something that we don't quite know yet?
I mean,
that doesn't really apply to what we're seeing here.
I think that discussion is a really good one, and I think we should have it the next Todd tournament on that live, like on that patch, because that's when it'll be. It's a podcast. It is a podcast kind of topic. Like we just get around a microphone for like 60 minutes.
Bam! Look
that's
at that.
We
got a round table right here.
I think that's a good play. Maybe I can curl up in like the fetal position when I'm kind of going through these patch notes.
Let's see it.
Demonstrate.
No, you're not calling me on that one. No,
show
it's
it.
Not happening.
Come on.
I don't think I'm quite ready for that
this
yet.
This thing has been here this entire week.
We haven't done it.
We haven't used this thing.
Go
it's just here. That's like old.
I need to do my laces.
I know, actually. It's like you try to put something on it. They're like, please don't do that.
Yeah, I'm going to get
a voice
in my head.
Yeah, we tried to place things on it. They keep telling us not to put things on.
But then, you know, table. Is this more of an ottoman?
It's an ottoman. It's a large ottoman, but it's not an ottoman.
I mean, we saw Samra again when you saw someone do something good. He was just like, huh! And then put it back.
It was getting close, it was.
It's good thing that it's soft. I nearly took out two ones.
So from meerkats to ottomans, we're getting sidetracked once again. What I do want to talk about is, of course, we have two semi-finalists secured. Let's go ahead and bring the brackets up so we can show you who they are and how they did it. We had, of course, Envious secure that first spot, besting Fnatic, and in a kind of rather convincing fashion, 2-0. Fnatic then falling to the lowers, and they'll be battling for their spot in the semifinals against the winner of Liquid Conquest, which is the next game we're going to be bringing you guys both at home and here live from the Burbank studios in Cologne. Then over onto the other side of the bracket. I mean, I'll let you walk us through this one, August.
No, I mean, we just saw the match now.
Yeah.
Question mark. Some would say decisive. I would say a very, very close 2-0 win over NaVi. They really came down to key rounds, and Zipnix, he came through for question mark to put them into that final. So they better be buying him a big steak tonight, you know, maybe a massage, something, you know, thanks, man. You know, it's a team activity,
yeah.
And, you know, take care of him, because ZipMix just played at a whole another level in this best of two.
Right. So best of three. Just a quick preview of the next best of three. I got you covered, bro. It's gonna be Liquid Conquest Blue.
Yeah, I mean, this is actually, I think Mega Man touched on it when he was sitting with us on the couch during the last game, is that this is actually going to be a rematch of that game from SivaLand just a couple months ago, where Conquest actually upset against it. The problem becomes, again, for Conquest, though, as I mentioned before in the opening portion of the stream, is they got absolutely crushed yesterday versus Fnatic. So we have to hope that, again, you know, the time between yesterday and today, they've had a little bit more time to just reset themselves and take a look at how they perform as a team, because if they're carrying any sort of baggage from that game yesterday, it's just going to impact them so badly, and it could just be a Liquid stomp, to be completely honest.
Potential Liquid stomp. Guys, little preview.
Much to our dismay, the blood god, Mo, is not here.
Yeah. That's very true as well.
He was actually kind of living up a little bit to that, to your prediction. You were hoping to see Mo drop bombs. Instead, though, we get the Elise Nitro combo, so I'm not too upset about the absence of Mo.
No, this is a full strength one. Liquid. Yeah. And so Conquest are going to have to hope that they've done their homework, that they're going to have a couple things up their sleeve, and that they can deal with that deadly combo over there. Because, yeah, Elise Nitro, hopefully, you know, Elise didn't take too much out of him doing these exams for school. Yeah, you know, he's able to get a good night's rest.
I sincerely hope so. I mean, I remember...
That's actually just... Sorry to interrupt. Yeah, that's actually going to be an interesting test, too, because that's been sort of a hot topic. At least Tico's brought that up a couple times now with this team as to where they've had trouble focusing themselves as a whole unit because of the fact that school and whatnot has gotten in the way. Yeah. You know, teams like XTSM have already proven that they can sort of...
It's a bit rich coming from Hiko, isn't it?
Well, yeah.
How many hours does he stream a day? Can somebody tell me that?
I don't actually know. I don't watch his stream too much. But
okay. Whoa. But Flame? Did you actually go there, Blue?
No, he streams too early. Oh, doesn't he stream like in the morning? I don't get up until at least noon.
He's got a gaming sleeping pattern.
Guy should be sleeping at least till noon, so he's got some decent energy going into the night.
But anyway, like that's a big thing he's been talking about is, you know, we have trouble focusing as a unit because we have these players that are focusing on school and whatnot. Say, and this is going to be a big test now that Liege is back and they're again playing as that full 5-man unit.
Because everybody knows, you know, like hugging all day is really good practice.
It is, yes. It's like DMing. It works, man. I have to try and be nice. I like Spence. I'm sorry.
I love him too.
We're hurting his feelings. But anyway, discussion will continue after our break. And before I go to that, I have to remind you about the Score Esports application. You better believe it. You can head over there both on your smartphone, but just head over in your browser as well to get your esports lowdown. I don't know where I'm supposed to be looking at this point.
Oh, my
so you can get your esports lowdown.
I'm done.
Both on your smartphone and on your browser. Articles as well. And the shoes are off. We're going to put our feet up, boys, as we wait this one out. And when we come back from our break, we'll be talking more about the game in hand. Liquid and Conquest. It's going to be awesome, guys. Don't go anywhere while we chill out on the Love Couch.